Her name was Carrie Shannon Payton. That's not something the Edmonton Police Service wanted you to know. She was murdered. That's not something they figured you needed to know either. On Thursday, Carrie Shannon Payton was found in her Blue Quill home, dead. Another body was lying beside her. The police revealed that two people had died. They said that one of the deaths was a homicide and the other was non-criminal. That's police code for domestic murder-suicide. And it's a code we've got to break. For 18 months now, the Edmonton Police Service has been deciding, seemingly arbitrarily, when to identify the victims of homicides and when to identify those accused in those homicides. There's no rhyme or reason to when they keep a name private. And in this case, one does have to wonder whether the fact that Carrie Shannon Payton was the daughter of a retired senior police officer had anything to do with the decision to impose this super level of secrecy. But it's time for this to end. It is inappropriate for the Edmonton Police Service to be deciding, case by case, when we know the names of someone who died and when we don't. And if we're serious about stopping domestic homicide, we have to know when those cases are happening. We have to know why Carrie Shannon died. We don't just need to know her name. We need to know the information that could have saved her life and that could save the lives of women in the future.